चुके हैं, तो आई थिंक वी शुड स्टार्ट द प्रोसीडिंग।
ओके
यस सर, थैंक यू सर।
सो गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू, चीफ गेस्ट एंड रिसोर्स पर्सन ऑफ दिस वेबिनार श्री अंकित कुमार सिंह जी, ही इज पीएचडी फ्रॉम आईआईटी रुड़की एंड एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन पटिया इन टीआईटी पटियाला, यस यस टीआईटी पटियाला, ऑर्गेनाइजर एंड कन्वेनर ऑफ दिस वेबिनार मिस्टर विवेक उपाध्याय, एचओडी एंड असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग ऑफ दिस इंस्टीट्यूट, स्टूडेंट कोऑर्डिनेटर मिस्टर विनीश भास्कर एंड भानु श्रीवास्तव, डियर फैकल्टी मेंबर्स एंड डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन दिस नेशनल लेवल सेमिनार ऑन इंट्रोडक्शन टू इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल चैलेंजेस अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन फ्यूचर वर्ल्ड। I'm not going into nitty-gritty of this, I mean the technical aspect of electric vehicle, but as a customer, whenever I think about my own vehicle or own car, what comes in our mind? In our mind, I think it is parameters first come. Comfort level, gadgets to make practically a smart vehicle that is equipped with Internet of Things, Artificial Intelligence, etc. Look wise, cost economy, eco-friendly, these five parameters, as a customer, these parameters come in our mind as a customer, what I think. But the major problem today in today's scenario is that how eco-friendly car can be manufactured so that it may produce less and less atmospheric pollution. All of we know that vehicles are a major pollution contributor, producing significant amounts of nitrogen oxide, carbon monoxide, and other pollution emitted into our air. Now I go back to the UN resolution that adopted in the General Assembly of United Nations on 25th September 2015. The main objective of that very resolution is transforming our world to ensure healthy lives and promote well-being for all at all stages, by 2030 तक हमें अपने एनवायरनमेंट को, अपने पूरे एटमॉस्फेयर को इस तरह से ट्रांसफॉर्म कर देना है कि हम सब एक हेल्दी लाइफ जी सकें हर एक स्टेज पे, फ्रॉम चाइल्डहुड अप टू ओल्ड एज, और इस एजेंडा को हमें पूरा कर लेना है 2030 तक। और इसके लिए यूएन असेंबली ने 17 सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स एंड 169 टारगेट्स आर फिक्स्ड बाय यूएन असेंबली how to proceed and what should be our road map to achieve that very goal. And the target number 3.9 of that resolution says that to substantially reduce the number of deaths and illness from hazardous chemicals, air, water, and soil pollution. This is the target number 3.9 of that UN resolution. So In that pretext or in that background, a green vehicle, today's requirement is a green vehicle or a clean vehicle or a eco-friendly vehicle or environmentally friendly vehicle, whatever we name it, that may produce less harmful impacts to the environment and comparable conventional internal combustion engine vehicles running on gasoline or diesel or one that uses certain alternative fuels. So today's requirement is to make eco-friendly car that can run on electricity or a combination of electricity and hydrogen-based fuel or a combination of solar energy and electricity. All these combinations we can think over. I think it's just such type of cars or vehicles are coming into market. So vehicles should be designed in such a way to reduce the sector's contribution to air pollution and climate change. And apart from the parameters as mentioned above, my simple suggestion or opinion is to think over for you technocrats, that the quality or technology of painting should also be thought of, so that the minimum use of water may be required to clean our vehicle, to get the vehicle clean. So I am not going to take so much of your time with this introductory remark. I end up my speech. We hope that this webinar will benefit our students. On behalf of GEC Vaishali, I convey my best wishes for this very successful webinar. And again, I extend a very warm welcome to our resource person. And I request sir now to enlighten our faculty members and the students through your scholarly speech. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Sir, I present now.
Yeah. Upadhyay.
Sir is starting the lecture.
Yeah. So please request your resource person to start.
सर शेयर कर रहे हैं स्क्रीन अपनी और जस्ट लेक्चर स्टार्ट कर रहे हैं.
हाँ,
स्क्रीन इज विजिबल.
यस, योर स्क्रीन इज विजिबल सर.
ओके. थैंक यू. फर्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक्स प्रिंसिपल जी सी डॉक्टर अनंत कुमार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर विवेक उपाध्याय एंड अदर फैकल्टी मेंबर्स ऑफ द जीईसी एंड स्टूडेंट कोऑर्डिनेटर्स for giving me such an opportunity to express my thoughts on the electric vehicles. I also welcome to the all the participants to joining this webinar. So title of this presentation is the introduction to electric vehicle challenges and opportunity in future. The content of this presentation is what is electric vehicle and why electric vehicles, downsides of the electric vehicle, power electronics as a driving agent for the vehicle, types of electric vehicles components, what are the various charging methodology, what are the charging technology, what are the motors for the EVs, challenges for EV adoption and opportunities for EV adoption. So electric vehicle or electric mobility is nothing but replacing the IC engine with electric motor, and that electric motor is propelled by the energy storage system like a battery. Reason for moving the gasoline powered vehicle to the electric vehicle is that gasoline, that is diesel or petrol, are a kind of a depleting source. Production shortage, sometimes oil spills can occur. We have to reliance on the oil import. Electric car pollute less than the oil powered cars. Electric cars are much more reliable and require less maintenance than gasoline powered car. Or even gasoline powered vehicle creates greenhouse gases like carbon monoxide, which is a poisonous and affects our planet, rising sea level, flooding, and etc. There are some downsides of the electric vehicle. That is, first and foremost is the range anxiety problem for the per charge. High cost of the electric vehicle due to the battery storage system. Battery is a very high, has a very high cost. Battery charging takes longer time than filling a gasoline powered vehicle. And once battery life is over, its disposal is also a kind of a challenge in the electric vehicle. So in the penetration of the electric vehicle markets, there are power electronics is an integral part, and it is a driving agent for the electric vehicle system. That is, we needed at every stage of electric vehicle, we need a converter system. That is power conversion during battery charging, power converters for feeding a driving motors, power converters for regeneration, means when there will be a regenerative braking, we will use that energy to charge the battery. So for that, we also need a converter. And power conditioning for the input power quality to maintain, as we know that at a grid side, we are always interested to maintain the high power factor and low total harmonic distortion. For that we also need a converter system. What are the various types of the electric vehicle? There are three major classifications of the electric vehicle. First one is the battery electric vehicle, second one is the hybrid electric vehicle, and third one is the plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. Hybrid electric vehicles further classified as a fuel cell and battery based hybrid electric vehicle, gasoline and a battery operated hybrid electric vehicle. So first is the battery operated electric vehicle. Battery operated electric vehicle is mainly powered by the electricity. There is no IC engine in the battery operated electric vehicle. It is also known as the plug-in electric vehicle to charge the battery. And this is the block diagram of battery operated electric vehicle. That is, first one is our utility grid, that is distribution voltage level, and then AC to DC converter. It may be the diode rectifier or maybe the power electronics based controlled rectifier. Then there will be a second stage, that is PFC, and a third stage, that is a non-isolated or kind of isolated DC-DC converter, which provides adequate voltage and current to the battery during the charging operation. And third one is the a converter we needed after the battery and DC to AC converter, that is bi-directional converter, which provides the power between battery and motor when there is a propulsion system. Then in propulsion system, battery will feed the power to this bi-directional converter to the electric motor. When there will be a regenerative braking, is DC to AC converter operates as an AC to DC converter, and it again provide energy to the battery and charge the battery, and which increases the per charge capability of the vehicle. Then there is a hybrid electric vehicle. Hybrid electric vehicle combines both IC engine and electrical propulsion system for the better fuel economy, powered by both engine and motor. And in this, battery is either charged by the through internally IC engine or charged by the regenerative braking, so that it requires less fuel consumption and reduce the exhaust gases due to two power sources. So further, hybrid electric vehicle categorized in two main groups. First one is the fuel cell and battery based hybrid electric vehicle. Second one is the gasoline and battery based hybrid electric vehicle. So in a fuel cell vehicle, that it produce the electricity using the hydrogen and oxygen, generate the electricity, and using this basically fuel cell generate a very low voltage. So we need a step up DC-DC converter to provide an adequate DC link voltage. DC link voltage is a voltage which is input to the DC to AC converter, and this DC to AC converter convert the DC power into AC power to drive the electric motor. Usually this part DC to AC converter may be not in all the vehicles, because if the motor is a DC type, then this converter is not needed DC to AC. So in kind of AC motors, like a three phase induction motor or a permanent magnet synchronous motor, so we need a DC to AC converter. And in this, there are two more systems are there, that is super capacitor and battery, which is a super capacitor which is charged by the regenerative braking energy, or only it is charged by the regenerative braking energy in this particular configuration. It may be charged by the other system also. Battery, which is also charged by the regenerative braking system. So both battery and supercapacitor provide energy to the electric motor. So second one is the gasoline, that is IC engine and electric motors. So in this, engine is directly providing power to the transmission system of the vehicle, and motor is also provide power to the transmission system of the vehicle, and the battery is charged by the regenerative braking system, or even some vehicle it is also possible we use a generator and AC-DC converter to charge the battery through the IC engine also. So that may be it is a part of it is optional in the gasoline and battery based hybrid electric vehicle. And the third one is the plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. So in plug-in hybrid electric vehicle, the difference between hybrid and plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. So in hybrid electric vehicle, we are not using the electrical external electricity, and in plug-in hybrid electric vehicle we use to charge the battery externally. Externally means our through the distribution grid, or even it can be charged by the engine also, or even by the regenerative braking process also. So there are three methods to charge the battery. It is externally through the distribution grid, and through the IC engine, and through the regenerative braking. So why it is a series why its name is a series plug-in hybrid electric vehicle? In a series plug-in hybrid electric vehicle, so only motor is provide power to the transmission system and wheel of the vehicle. Only the motor will responsible for the providing a power. And second one is the in a plug-in hybrid electric vehicle is the parallel plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. So here motor and IC engine both providing power to the transmission system of the vehicle, and all other things are same as a series plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. Electric vehicle components. This is the complete components of a electric vehicle. First one is that there will be an onboard charging system. If it is onboard charging means the charger will be inside the vehicle and it will be connected to the grid. Or if the vehicle will charge by the fast charging method, so fast charging method is nothing but a onboard charger. I will discuss later. So that fast charger will be not inside the vehicle, it will be always outside the vehicle because of its heavy weight and size. So there will be again battery, supercapacitor, battery, and these battery and supercapacitor are always connected to the high voltage DC system through the bi-directional DC-DC converter. These two converter always were the bi-directional in nature. Bi-directional means power flow can both direction from supercapacitor to the high voltage DC link, high voltage to the supercapacitor, and similarly for the battery system. There will be also a auxiliary battery. It is called as a low voltage battery system to provide auxiliary power sources within the vehicle. Auxiliary power sources like for the wiper, lighting system of the vehicle. So we need a low voltage DC-DC converter. It will just step down the high voltage DC link to the low voltage DC link and to charge the auxiliary battery. And definitely there will be a three-phase inverter in case of AC motor. And there will be a AC motor. It may be the permanent magnet or an induction motor. And there will be a transmission system. This is the complete components of any electric vehicle system. It depending upon the vehicle, some components may be not a part of the vehicle. So charging methodology. There are two major classification of the charging. First one is the onboard charging. It is also called as a slow charging or overnight charging. Means battery will takes longer time to charge, and it is usually done at our houses or our work office. And second one is the offboard charging method. This is known as a fast charging methods. So these are two basic charger which is we use for the charging the electric vehicle. This is the voltage and power level classification of different kind of charger. This is the AC level one. In this, the nominal voltage range is a 120 volt. It is usually popular, and here the frequency will be the 60 hertz, which is not in the case of India, and it will mostly popular in the America. The power range is a typical 1.4 to 1.9 kilowatt. And second AC level two, in the here is the voltage range is the 208 and 240 volt AC. And this is the further classified as a mode one, mode two, mode three, depending upon the power level. In mode one, we use a 3.6 kilowatt to 11. In mode two, 3.6 kilowatt to 20 kilowatt. It is primarily used for the residential office are some basic charging station. And mode 3, it requires a special socket to connect the vehicle to the our grid system. So this is the power range is around 3.6 kilowatt to 20 kilowatt. And AC level 3 is not finalized yet. Then there and then four types of the charging level is the DC level charger, or it is a fast it is also known as the fast charger. So there are three classification of voltage range, that is 200 to 450 volt, and second one is the also 200 to 450 volt, and third one is the 200 to 600 volt. This is known as a DC level 1, this is the DC level 2, and this is the DC level 3. The power range of the DC level 1 is the 36 kilowatt or above to 80, and the current rating is the 80 amperes, and in DC level 2 is the 90 kilowatt, 200 ampere, and DC level 3 is the 240 kilowatt and 400 ampere. And this is basically the fast charger or DC level charger, not used at our houses or even at work home. It is generally used for the public, so it is for the public, it name as a public station. So in the charging mode, charging technology for the AC, that it refers the home charging from our standard socket which is present at houses, and it does not provide any shock protection against the DC current. In mode 2 charging, a dedicated cable is provided with the AB, and it has an inbuilt protection with the cable. And mode 2 charging is most popular methods for the AC charging method. Here I also give one point, that what AC charging and DC charging, what is the meaning of the charging? Battery always takes the DC power only. So AC charge, when we say that this is the AC charging method, it means that we are connecting directly AC supply to the vehicle, and there will be a charger inside the vehicle which will convert AC into DC, again some DC to other DC level. But in case of DC charging method, we are directly give power to the vehicle. So rectification and all other process will be done outside the vehicle. Mode 3 charging, in mode 3 charging methods, it is popular for both AC and DC currents, and there will be a separate separate cable and wall box or a charging station will be used in a mode 3 charging method. And it is also popular for the charging of the electric vehicles. So mode 4 is referred as a DC fast charging or simply a fast charger. So the power range in a mode 4 is around even in the range of 40 kilowatts. It may reaches up to the 150 kilowatt, 150 kilowatt or near to 200 kilowatt. So this is the connection diagram of mode 1 to mode 2. In mode 1, there is simple, we connect our cable to our household socket. And in mode 2, there will be a communication system will be there. Their communication system means that how much SOC has been raised of the vehicle. So many communications will take place during the charging of the battery. And third one is the, that is mode 3, this is the wall box. We will not connect our cable to directly our socket, our home socket, or any common socket. There will be separate charging panel will be there, and the communication and control will be also provided with the mode 3. And third one is the fourth one will be the AC or DC fast charging. It can provide, provide AC supply directly to the vehicle or DC supply to the vehicle. Electric vehicle supply equipment. This is the assembly of electric vehicle supply equipment. It provides the energy from our grid to the battery. There will be all control and communication system will be in the electric vehicle supply equipment. So there is another concept in the EV charging technology which is being popular and are going to very much popular in the future, that is a battery swapping station. So the battery swapping station, in this we will replace our discharge battery with the fully charged new battery in within 1 or 2 minutes. So at the battery swapping station, there will be different processes will take place for the, like payment and some services for the battery. So in this system is also many points is here that means if a consumer or a customer has not a sufficient money to replace the battery, so it will pay some money and take the battery, and depending upon how much he has paid the money, he will use the energy, and energy operator have some remote control mechanism. If he will exceed, if his money, the amount of energy he has used according to his money, so battery operation automatically will stop. So this is also a kind of facility in a battery swapping station. So it is we can say similar to like our home gas cylinder. When it is completely empty, we go to the cylinder station, we replace our empty cylinder to the completely filled station. So like that, but in battery swapping technology, we will take the completely charged battery to the we will replace our completely discharged battery to the completely charged battery. So there are some design standard which is published by some our Society of Automatic Engineer that ये कई बार ये होता है कि सम ड्राइवर को ये रहता है कि उनका व्हीकल चार्ज हो पाएगा कि नहीं इस पर्टिकुलर स्टेशन पे. सो फॉर दैट टू रिमूव दैट एंजाइटी द सोसाइटी ऑफ ऑटोमेटिक इंजीनियर पब्लिश्ड सम स्टैंडर्ड एंड दैट स्टैंडर्ड विल बी अडॉप्टेड बाय एवरी ऑटोमेकर्स वॉलेंटियरली. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट standard which is popularly used by every automakers, that is Society of Automatic Engineers J1772. It is used for the AC and DC both, and it is also only it also recommends only for the conductive charging. There are also wireless charging system is also going to grow in a future, but it is it deals only about the conductive charging system. So another kind of standard that is which is based upon the Japanese manufacturer, that is CADEMO, but CADEMO covers only for the DC fast charging stations. So in the this is the a diagram of the J1772 EV sockets here, that AC power pins are there. So for the to charge the vehicle through the AC supplies, there will be some communication pins also there. Some it will be the ground pin there, and there will be the connection detection pins also there. And second one is the second standard in SAE J1772 is the for the DC fast charging. It is a in DC fast charging the socket, there will be both types of pins available, AC and DC both. This is the for the high power charging pin. High power charging means it is for the DC power supply, and this will be the low power charging pins, and all other communication pins will be there, connection detection pins will be there. This is the also known as the J1772 combo EV socket. So and third one is the I already told that CADEMO standard, that is it is used for only for the DC system. So it provides the higher power to the vehicle. DC power always used to provide a high power to the battery to charge the battery in a less time. So and third one is a Tesla supercharging station. Till now there is no public standard for the supercharging stations, means power rating is still not defined. It can provide a very high power to the vehicle, and the vehicle can be charged within a few minutes using the Tesla supercharging station, and it is automatically support both AC and DC system. So this is the system for the EV charging. That is a first one will be the always a grid side converter. It is a kind of AC to DC, and the second one will be the DC to DC converter. DC to DC converter will provide adequate voltage and current level to charge the battery, and it will be the integral part of both of the onboard charging system or even a offboard charging system. So I will show some popular topologies for AC to DC converter, which is used in an electric vehicle. This is the first one, is the interleaved boost converter topology. Here two parallel switches are used in a basic. This is derived from the basic boost converter. Okay, basic boost converter. So there will be a two power switches and two inductors connected in a parallel to increase the power level capacity of the converter, and these switches operate in a 180 degree out of phase to reduce the input current ripple at a grid side. And there will be a DC-DC converter I will discuss later. And the second one is the three level boost converter. Basically, as we know that stress to reduce the stress on the switches, if you will reduce the stress on the switches, we can increase the power rating of the we can provide a higher power to the battery. So this is the in a three level, we are reducing the voltage level, voltage stress across the switches by connecting a two capacitor at the DC link point. And the third one is the this is the bridgeless topology. In a bridgeless topology, we remove the diode rectifier with two switches. So in due to this bridgeless topology, the semiconductor devices number of semiconductor devices reduces in the current part, so that efficiency and loss efficiency can be improved and losses can be decreased. So this is the fourth one, is the bridgeless interleaved topology. Whatever I have discussed, the interleaved and bridgeless interleaved, it is the combination of both to increase the power level capacity of the charging system. So there are some bidirectional topologies are there. As we know that in electric vehicle, we always not take the power from the grid. Sometimes when battery has excess energy, if battery is charged by the solar power, so to manage the grid, so we are interested to provide a power to the grid system. So for that, we need a bidirectional converter. These are some popular topology which is used for in a electric vehicle as a bidirectional converter. So this is the half bridge topology, this is the full bridge AC-DC converter as we know it, and this is the three phase full bridge topology will be there. And then in when we are using a bidirectional topology, both AC-DC and DC-DC will have a bidirectional in nature. And there are some popular topologies in the bidirectional DC-DC converter. This is the simple boost. If you replace in a boost converter diode with the switches, so this topology will form and it provides energy from AC to DC and DC to AC. And second one is this is a popular inverting buck boost converter. We might have studied in a power electronic system. So this is the it is also has a buck and boost, buck boost capability in both the direction. Meet it can step up or step down the voltage in a both directions. And third, and this is the third one, which is a full bridge DC-DC converter. And these are the some complete topology isolated type which is used to charge the battery. This is the isolated full bridge LLC resonant converter. So it is used mainly for the light electric vehicle. And for the high power application, this is a kind of a 3x1 matrix converter to provide a high power to the vehicle system. In a high power application, usually we always prefer to the isolation between grid and battery side for the safety of the user of the vehicle. So now I will discuss here how will we choose the motor for the EV system? What are the basic requirement of the motor? So motor, the motor will be should be it should have a high power density capability, and it should have a high torque at low speed for the starting purpose or even at a climbing purpose, and it should have a high wide range of speed in a constant power region, fast torque response, and high efficiency during a wide speed range of operation with constant torque or a constant power region. So and high efficiency during regenerative braking. Regenerative braking when take place. So to charge the battery, we use the regenerative braking energy. So so motor will should have a high efficiency during regenerative braking also. And basically motors are always inside the vehicle. So our objective also the size of the motor should be less, and it should have a low moment of inertia, and it should also have should have a reasonable cost and fault tolerance capability. So these are the four popular EV motors. First one is the brushless DC motor. Second one is the permanent magnet synchronous motor. This is known as a PMSM. Third one is the induction motor. And fourth one is the switch reluctance motor. So I will discuss one by one. Brushless DC motor mainly popular for the low powered vehicle like a two wheelers or a three wheelers. So in comparison to the induction motor, brushless DC motor are expensive to manufacture, but it has a lighter in weight, compact in a size. So mainly China producing more BLDC motor, that is brushless DC motor, in a huge number, and all over the world completely China is supplying the BLDC motor. So due to the more availability and good performance capability of BLDC motor, it is almost used in a light electric vehicle. These are the some light electric vehicles model which they are using BLDC motor, that is electric scooters, that TVS Crayon 22 motor, Hero Electric, all they are using the BLDC motors. Then second one is the permanent magnet synchronous motor. Permanent magnet synchronous motor used for the some high power application. So the beauty of the permanent magnet synchronous motor is that it has a very high power density and high efficiency. So due to that, it is very much popular in the electric vehicle system. But only drawback of the permanent magnet synchronous motor is that magnet may be demagnetizing, may be demagnetized at a high current. So this is the only major problem with the permanent magnets. That's why when a very far very high power, we will means when we are going to above 20-30 kilowatts, so we are limiting to not recommended to use a PMSM. For that we go for the induction motor. So some popular electric car model, that is a four wheelers, use a permanent magnet motor, that is a Chevy Volt, Nissan Leaf, Toyota, they are all using the permanent magnet motor. Induction motor, as we know that induction motor, among all the motors, induction motor is the one of the most matured AC motor. And due to its availability, its availability from fractional horsepower to megawatt power level, and it has a very good control strategy during a constant power region. Only drawback compared to the permanent magnet motor, which is significant, is that it has a lower efficiency compared to permanent magnet due to presence of the rotor losses. There are a separate winding in the rotor, as we know that in induction motor. Due to that, there will be high losses in induction motor. And another problem with that, it operates on a low power factor because of the exciting current. Tesla models, all the Tesla models are using the induction motor. Tesla Model S, Tesla Model X, S, and even Mahindra are using the induction motor. Third one is the switch reluctance motor. It is not too much popular in the EV system. That is only good point about the switch reluctance motor has that it has very simple control strategy and provide a wide range of the wide range of speed control in the constant power region. But it has some major drawback that high torque ripple is there in a switch reluctance motor, which affects the performance of our complete drive system and electric vehicle. And what are the challenges for the EV adoption? So there are we have talked about much the electric vehicle. So still there are many challenges why the people are still not adopting the electric vehicles. That First one is the charging infrastructure. Due to the unavailability, unavailability of the charging infrastructures, people are not preferring the electric vehicles. So original equipment manufacturer which provide the which offering the home charging solution for the customer with EV to just kick start of the EV markets. Another major problem is, it is one of the biggest problem is still for the electric vehicle, that the range anxiety problem, that the driver has always anxiety that whether at per charge I will reach our destination or not. So this is the major disadvantage of the electric, major challenge we can say, not a disadvantage for the EV adoption. So this is can be handled by the in the research in the battery system. So by reducing the compactness, increasing the energy density, so range anxiety problems can be mitigated. And the third one is the government policies. So lack of proper government policy, we cannot penetrate the EV market. Some countries like USA, China, Norway, Brazil has started giving a kind of incentive subsidies to assist the market penetration of EV. So without a proper government policy, it is difficult to promote the EV market, because of the cost of the EV is very high compared to the IC engine. And it is, and a reason behind the high cost is the battery system of the vehicle. And the third, fourth challenge, which is for the EV adoption, that is integration of electric vehicle within the product portfolio of OEM. What is the meaning of this? That we already, some companies are making cars, some making the charger. So उनको अपनी एग्जिस्टिंग टेक्नोलॉजी में भी बहुत सारे चेंजेस करने पड़ रहे हैं, तो वो भी एक काइंड ऑफ अ मेजर चैलेंज फॉर द इन ईवी एडॉप्शन. सो व्हाट आर द अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन ईवी एडॉप्शन? सो देयर इज अ फर्स्ट ए मींस कि क्या क्या हमारे पास अपॉर्चुनिटी होंगी अगर हम ईवी को अडॉप्ट करते हैं फ्यूचर में, कैसे हमारा बिजनेस ग्रो हो सकता है, कैसे हमारा जो है हमारा एक स्टूडेंट के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से उसका कैसे करियर बन सकता है. सो इन ईवी देयर वाज अ कैंपेन इन 2017, दैट इज इट इज नोन एज ईवी 30 एट द रेट 30 कैंपेन. सो देयर आर 13 कंट्रीज व्हिच हैव पार्टिसिपेटेड इन दिस कैंपेन, दैट इज कनाडा, फ्रांस, जापान, नॉर्वे, चिली, जर्मनी, नीदरलैंड, स्वीडन, चाइना, इंडिया, न्यूजीलैंड, यूनाइटेड किंगडम एंड फिनलैंड. सो देयर ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू इंक्रीज द 30% ऑफ द मार्केट शेयर फॉर द इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल compared to all the vehicles by 2030. So 2030 तक इनका जो objective है कि 30% हमारे जो vehicle हैं वो electric vehicle होने चाहिए, except two wheelers. इन ये हमारे 13 country का जो है agenda है. So another opportunity in adoption of the electric vehicle, that solar PV generation and EV are stimulating each other. In why? Because solar has always has excess energy. We cannot always put all the solar energy into the grid. So when there will be a excess energy, we can store that energy into the battery. And if the excess in that energy will be stored in the battery, we can use those energy later to feed the grid. Or even we can if the we have a do not require to feed the grid, so just vehicle can run by the solar energy system. So this is the, they are promoting to each other, means if there will be large number of vehicle in the market, so solar energy, which is excess solar energy, can energy can be put into the battery of the electric vehicle. And as day by day, the cost of the lithium-ion battery, which is mostly popular in the electric vehicle due to high energy density, its cost is going reduce and reduce. That in 2012, its cost was $600 per kWh. In 2017, it was $250 per kWh, and we are expecting that's $100 per kWh by 2024. So some data which is showing that how the EV market is growing worldwide. When we talk about in 2010, only 17,000 electric cars were on the world road, but by 2019, that numbers had swelled to, means increased to 7.2 million. But 47% of the increased in 7.2 million, 47% electric cars has grown in Republic of China. So this is the passenger electric car data and market share between 2013 to 2019. That here a dark shade is showing for the battery operated electric vehicle. Battery operated means purely battery operated. Means its names already I told that plug-in hybrid electric, plug-in electric vehicle. And second one is the light shade shows the plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. This is here shown that in China we means battery operated electric vehicles are growing much faster than the plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. It and it is a similar in USA also, and in European countries somewhat a similar kind of increase we can see in battery operated and light and battery operated and plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. We can see here in Germany we can see dark and light shade both are comparable to each other, means that battery operated electric vehicle and plug-in hybrid electric vehicle both are growing at same pace. And we can see even in a United Kingdom like this way, in same fashion, battery and plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. So these are the data which is showing that how the electric vehicles market is growing the worldwide. So when we talk about in context to India, National Electric Mobility Mission Plan 2020 and its recommendation came to promote the EV markets. So for that, there are some guidelines which I will show here, that adequate capacity addition primarily through the renewable energy sources in a distribution grid in order to meet the additional demand created by the high penetration of the EV. Means iska matlab ye hai ki hum renewable energy ko jyada se jyada apne grid mein jo hai introduce karenge, jisse ki hum jo additional demand hai hamari wo EV ko mil sake jo hai solar se. And EV charging station to be designed preferably with the rooftop solar generation to minimize the dependency on the fossil fuel. This is the recommendation of the National Electric Mobility Mission. And our EV manufacturer ko encourage kiya ja raha hai ki that they design the vehicle with changeable battery so that EV owner can just move to the charging station and replace his battery with the fully charged battery. And charging station can plan to aisi jagah humko charging station banane hai jahan pe ye humko ye dekhna hai ki wahan ka जो डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन का वोल्टेज प्रोफाइल है वो आपका कम ना हो, तो ऐसे भी हमको चार्जिंग स्टेशंस ऐसी ही जगह बनानी है, इसको भी गवर्नमेंट का रिकमेंडेशन है. और यूज ऑफ डायनेमिक प्राइसिंग मॉडल फॉर एंड स्मार्ट ग्रिड टूल फॉर द चार्जिंग स्टेशन टू इनकरेज द चार्जिंग एट नॉन पीक टाइमिंग. मीन्स कि अगर हम डायनेमिक प्राइसिंग मीन्स कि अगर आप इस समय चार्ज करते हैं जब हमारा पीक टाइम नहीं है तो आपको लेस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल पे करना होगा. एंड इट्स जस्ट टू एडिंग द पीक लोड मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम ऑफ द पावर सिस्टम. एंड एडॉप्शन ऑफ द ईवी चार्जिंग कनेक्टर स्टैंडर्ड, ये आपको ऐसा सोसाइटी आप जो ऑटोमेटिक इंजीनियर एसोसिएशन ऑफ इंडिया है उसको भी ऐसे कनेक्टर्स डिजाइन करने हैं जो कि सभी व्हीकल्स को सपोर्ट कर सकें इजली, जो अलग अलग कार मैन्युफैक्चरर हैं इलेक्ट्रिक कार मैन्युफैक्चरर. एंड ऑल्सो यूटिलिटी सैंक्शन द इंस्टॉलेशन ऑफ चार्जिंग पॉइंट्स एट होम फॉर ईवी चार्जिंग बेस्ड ऑन अवेलेबल कैपेसिटी ऑफ द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ग्रिड इन दैट एरिया. So another which is in the last week of the month of July, that Indian government has shown interest to invest a 50,000 crore opportunity in India by 2020, which shows that to how the electric vehicle market will increase in India. So this is the report which is given by the Vendus Capital, a kind of investment banking system which provide a financial support to the industry. So this is the all about of this presentation. So if there is a queries, I'm ready to answer the queries of the students, faculties.
Hello, sir. One query is from the faculty member, and the question is how to balance the voltage stability due to charging stations?
Voltage stability, it is voltage stability. We can say that if there will be a large number of electric vehicle system, so definitely there will be a problem of the low voltage at at a distribution level grid. So for that we have to manage the means we can cut the charging of the vehicle, or we can promote the we can integrate the solar power to the our grid system, so that stability can be improved. It is completely depends upon the how we have forecasted our load system. So if there will be large number of vehicle, definitely the problem of voltage will be there. So for that, that's why our Indian government we are promoting the charging of the vehicle at a charging station through the solar system, so that problems can be mitigated or will be mitigated by the by incorporating more and more number of the solar system, so that we can maintain the stability.
Thank you, sir. One more question is there. What is the fate of this electrical vehicle system in India in coming 1-2 years? Means what will be the expected growth in India as far as electrical vehicles are concerned?
As far as there are two, as I have shown that even EV 30 at the 30 campaign is also India is willing to increase EV market around 30% by 2030, and even a government policies also in the month of July, this month of last week of the July, so that we are interested to invest around 50,000 crore rupees for the on a two wheelers and a three wheelers system. So India is actively participating and giving, and also in the month of this month of August, on 12 August, that Indian government is also giving subsidy that battery swapping station, that you need not to pay the cost of the battery. You can take rent, or a charging station will take, you can buy your vehicle without the battery cost, and that will be and that battery will be taken by the energy operator, that means which is present at means a swapping station, or even you can take the on the rent basis the battery with the vehicle. So this is the also a just it is on 12th August, this is the report of Indian government.
Yes. Okay. One more question is there. Can we transform IC engine into electrical vehicles, example like CNG vehicles?
Means what? I'm not getting question.
One student has put this question that can we transform the IC engine into electric vehicles, or example like example like CNG vehicles.
Okay. IC engine है तो वो है hybrid, जो pure hybrid electric vehicle का concept है, that is based upon the उसमें IC engine है. और सब देखिए कुछ उसमें एडिशनल मॉडिफिकेशन हमको चाहिए ही चाहिए हाइब्रिड इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल में आईसी इंजन के साथ, कि आपका बैटरी भी रखना है और मोटर को भी रखना है। तो ये एक टेक्नोलॉजिकल लेवल पे इसको देखना पड़ेगा कि क्या है उसमें, कैसे कार मैन्युफैक्चरर उसको उसमें कर रहा है, कैसे वो लोग उसको इनकॉर्पोरेट कर सकते। बट लेकिन ये एक बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज है कि वो एग्जिस्टिंग उनका जो भी टेक्नोलॉजी सिस्टम है उसमें उसको इनकॉर्पोरेट करना एक काइंड ऑफ ईवी में, ईवी अडॉप्शन में चैलेंज ही है। तो ये कंप्लीटली आई थिंक वी कैन नो बाय द हाउ द कैसे वो कार मैन्युफैक्चरर जो है उसको कैसे इस बात को हैंडल करेंगे, इसका एग्जैक्ट बहुत आइडिया आई एम नॉट एबल टू आंसर एट दिस पॉइंट एग्जैक्टली कैसे होगा। ओके
सर, वन मोर क्वेश्चन इज देयर एनी अल्टरनेटिव ऑफ द लिथियम आयन बैटरी?
लिथियम आयन बैटरी का अभी तक जो है देखो लो पावर में, जो लो पावर या लो कॉस्ट व्हीकल है उसमें तो हम लोग लेड एसिड बैटरी यूज कर रहे हैं, बट लिथियम आयन बैटरी का जो कॉस्ट भी रिड्यूस हो रहा है और डे बाय डे जो है इसका एनर्जी ड्यू टू रिसर्च तो एनर्जी डेंसिटी भी इंक्रीज हो रही है, तो उससे हमारा साइज एकदम रिड्यूस हो रहा है। तो बट उससे इसका तो कोई और कंपटीटर तो दिख नहीं रहा है। तो एक दो बैटरी, एक जैसे निकिल मेटल हाइड्राइड है, निकिल कैडमियम बैटरी है, ये है, लेकिन ये उतना पॉपुलर व्हीकल में नहीं है। मतलब ये चीज है, ओनली लिथियम आयन इज डोमिनेटिंग कंप्लीटली इन द व्हीकल सिस्टम, खासकर हाई पावर में तो व्हीकल में तो है ये है ड्यू टू इट्स हाई एनर्जी डेंसिटी।
सर एक क्वेश्चन और है कि विच वन इज बेटर, हाइड्रोजन व्हीकल और इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल?
फ्यूल सेल जो है वो कि प्रॉब्लम ये है कि उसमें एक लार्ज स्पेस की रिक्वायरमेंट होती है, उसका जो भी सिस्टम होता है हाइड्रोजन ऑक्सीजन से जो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेट करने का होता है वो एक लार्ज स्पेस की रिक्वायरमेंट होती है, वो अभी तक इतना पॉपुलर नहीं है
के साथ व्हीकल। यस यस सर, एक क्वेश्चन और है कि वुड देयर बी एडवर्स इफेक्ट ऑन आवर नेशनल ग्रिड इफ लॉट्स ऑफ ईवी चार्जर्स आर साइमल्टेनियसली कनेक्टेड ऑन द ग्रिड ड्यू टू हार्मोनिक्स जनरेटेड बाय द चार्जर्स?
हाँ, देखो ये जो है ना ड्यू टू पावर क्वालिटी और पावर ड्यू टू कन्वर्टर सिस्टम ड्यू टू एक्सीलेंट कंट्रोल स्ट्रेटजी, ये हम लोग बहुत इजीली इसको मैनेज कर लेंगे, ये इतना चैलेंज नहीं रहेगा। ठीक है, और एडिशनल पावर डिमांड तो हम सोलर से ले लेंगे, एंड पावर क्वालिटी की जो प्रॉब्लम है ड्यू टू इंजेक्शन ऑफ द हार्मोनिक्स थ्रू द एक्सीलेंट कंट्रोल स्ट्रेटजी ऑफ द पावर कन्वर्टर सिस्टम वी कैन हैंडल इट वेरी इजीली, मींस वी कैन प्रिवेंट बिकॉज वी आल्सो डिड वर्क ऑन द पावर क्वालिटी, सो कंप्लीटली यूनिटी पावर फैक्टर वी आर मेंटेनिंग एट ड्यूरिंग द बैटरी चार्जिंग, इट इज नॉट अ बिग प्रॉब्लम।
यस 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 सर, वन मोर क्वेश्चन इज देयर, कंसीडरिंग द लिमिटेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल कार विद रिस्पेक्ट टू चार्जिंग अवेलेबिलिटी, why don't what? we go for the sir considering the limitation of electrical car with respect to charging availability?
Okay.
why don't we go for the hybrid model?
Why we go for the hybrid model? Hybrid model, sir, is still there is a challenge for that na range anxiety problem, that when you have a hybrid model means a fuel means IC engine and battery operated, you can increase your you can range can be extended, because pure electric vehicle has this is the problem with the people are preferring the hybrid electric vehicles, that they can for high means a four wheelers are even four wheeler because of that only that range can be extended easily. Another thing, you know that in a hybrid electric vehicle along with the IC we can reduce the size of the IC engine also, and we can increase the complete fuel economy in the hybrid electric vehicle, because when IC engine will run, सपोज दैट गाड़ी हमारी खड़ी है वहां पे आपका ट्रैफिक पे, तो उस समय इंजन जो चल रहा है वहां पे आईसी इंजन की इफिशियंसी जो है वो इतनी है नहीं कि आपका फ्यूल कंजम्पशन बहुत ज्यादा, अगर वहीं पे हम बैटरी से उसको ऑपरेट करते रहते हैं तो बैटरी हमारा कन्वर्टर सिस्टम मोटर की इफिशियंसी हाई होने की वजह से जो है वो हम फ्यूल काफी बचा लेते हैं हाइब्रिड इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल में। जी
यस ओके सो आई थिंक सर क्वेश्चंस आर ओवर एंड नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट द फैकल्टी मेंबर ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूशन इफ दे वांट टू टॉक टू रिस्पेक्टेड सर दे कैन टॉक all the faculty member the floor is open for you all thank you any queries from faculty member present please Anil sir
hello
yes yes
ye mujhe jankari leni thi sir pehle to main aapko mere taraf se main aapko hardik abhinandan sir aur bahut bahut dhanyawad jo hai aap yahan hum log ko jo hai जानकारी दे रहे हैं इसके लिए
थैंक यू सर
गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू सर मैं ये जानना चाहता हूँ कि जैसे हम लोग जो है आईसी इंजन में जो है सॉफ्ट पावर जो है हम लोग को आईसी इंजन मिलता है और हम लोग उसमें फ्यूल यूज करते हैं तो इसमें हमको डायरेक्ट सॉफ्ट एनर्जी विदाउट फ्यूल जनरेट यूज किए हुए कैसे मिलता है हम लोग को
किसमें किसमें सर कैसे अब एक बार फिर से
आईसी इंजन में सर जो है उसमें तो सिलेंडर रहता है सर जो है
और
ये जो है हम लोग को जो है पावर एक्सपेंशन जो है पावर जो सब जो होता है जब पावर सप्लाई जो होता है फोर स्पॉट जो होता है ना सर सक्शन कंप्रेशन एक्सपेंशन मींस पावर सप्लाई तो एक्सपेंशन में हम लोग को जो है वो शाफ्ट पर पावर हम लोग को मिलता है और शाफ्ट मूव करता है जिसके कारण जो है उसका जो है आपका शाफ्ट रोटेट करता है तो इसमें हम लोग जो है कैसे शाफ्ट को रोटेट करते हैं
शाफ्ट को कैसे रोटेट करते हैं सर इसमें वो ट्रांसमिशन और गियर सिस्टम होते हैं इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स में जो कि हमारा इंजन जो भी आईसी इंजन है और मोटर दोनों ही उस ट्रांसमिशन सिस्टम से कनेक्टेड रहते हैं जो है कि उसको रोटेट उसी के थ्रू कराते हैं उसमें ट्रांसमिशन कपलर होता है तो ये थोड़ा सा डिटेल जो है सर एज वी नो वी आर फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल बैकग्राउंड तो थोड़ा मैकेनिकल पार्ट है इसमें इन्वॉल्व हो रहा है तो आई थिंक ये है लेकिन वो ट्रांसमिशन और गियर से हम इस चीज को अपने पावर को आईसी इंजन को और मोटर को ट्रांसमिट करते हैं फील्ड में सर
और सर एक और क्वेश्चन जो है लाइक आईसी इंजन में जो भी गियर जो है सिस्टम होता है जैसे हम लोग जो है फर्स्ट गियर सेकेंड गियर थर्ड गियर जो भी होता है उसमें जो है हम लोग क्या करते हैं जो फर्स्ट गियर में जो है होता है कि जो है वो छोटा पिनियन जो है बड़ा गियर को जो है रोटेट करता है तो हमारा जो स्पीड कम होता है तो लाइक इसमें भी वैसा ही मैकेनिज्म जो होता है कि अलग से कुछ ऐसा है
नहीं नहीं सर वैसा ही मैकेनिज्म नहीं 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 ऐसे ही सेम मैकेनिज्म है सर गियर डिफरेंट फॉर गियर सिस्टम आर देयर इन वो हाइब्रिड इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स में ही बात आएगी सो ठीक है सर हाइब्रिड इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल में वो सेम वही होगा ये है सर ये चीज है
और दूसरी बात एक और क्वेश्चन पूछना था सर जो है जैसे हम लोग जो है आईसी इंजन में जो हम लोग फ्यूल सप्लाई करते हैं तो आपका इंडिकेटेड हॉर्स पावर जो होता है ग्रेटर देन ब्रेक हॉर्स पावर होता है और जो है उसमें सब लॉसेस होते हैं जैसे फ्रिक्शन लॉसेस होते हैं पिस्टन वगैरह में तो इस टाइप का लॉसेस कुछ होते हैं क्या जो पावर जनरेशन करने में
पावर जनरेशन में सर इन केस आप इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स में अगर हमारा सर देखिए सर हाइब्रिड इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल है तो जो चीजें कम हो रही हैं हमारा मैकेनिकल पार्ट जो था वो वैसे ही है ठीक है सर और केवल तो बैटरी
सिलेंडर इसमें सिलेंडर नहीं होता है ना सर ये जो आपने बताया कि ये दिस इज नॉट आईसी इंजन
कौन सा सर किसमें
इसमें जो आप बताया जो इलेक्ट्रिक जनरेटर जो भी इंजन होता है वो आईसी इंजन नहीं होता है इंटरनल कम्बशन इंजन नहीं होता है मीन्स इसमें कम्बशन नहीं होता है मीन्स आपका इसमें सिलेंडर नहीं होगा
सिलेंडर सर फ्यूल टैंक की बात कर रहे हैं आप
जी हाँ
फ्यूल टैंक तो हाँ
फ्यूल टैंक की मैं बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ सर जो आईसी इंजन में क्या होता है कि हम लोग जो है उसमें पिस्टन जो है जो भी फोर स्ट्रोक इंजन है तो हम लोग जो है फोर स्ट्रोक में जो होता है अपना पहला स्ट्रोक होता है सक्शन स्ट्रोक ये सक्शन स्ट्रोक में जो है आपका
हेलो हेलो
आई थिंक अनिल सर का सर कनेक्शन जो है वो लॉस हो गया है तो लेट
हेलो सर
सो हाँ हाँ गौरव जी बोलिए
हेलो सर आई एम गौरव घोष फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल डिपार्टमेंट आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन सर लाइक व्हाट इज द फ्यूचर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल फॉर स्टार्टअप because nowadays like it is not in commercial way so how can we increase increase its production
production I mean sir there are all the in India also we can say Tata and Mahindra they are all are manufacturing the means these low powered vehicle are even फोर व्हीलर्स व्हीकल तो बट लेकिन हम लोग एज अ बिजनेस के पॉइंट एंड स्टार्टअप के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से अगर बात करें तो सो एज मींस चार्जिंग इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर देयर विल बी लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटी इन अ चार्जिंग इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर सो वी कैन इन्वेस्ट इन द टू इन द चार्जिंग इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर टू ग्रो आवर बिजनेस
एंड सर लाइक इज देयर एनी गवर्नमेंट इंसेंटिव for this
government incentives there are means abhi isme ye abhi ye sab cheeze bahut india mein just implement ke matlab work bhi hai hone ke jaise jo hai delhi government ne abhi state wise bhi implement ho rahi hai lekin abhi puri completely nahi hai india mein jaise दिल्ली में अभी जस्ट कुछ दिन पहले ही इंसेंटिव देने की सब्सिडी देने की बात कही है केजरीवाल ने अभी लोगों का अभी ये हमारा मतलब कि बिगनिंग स्टेज पे ही है मतलब कि कैसे उसको देना है इंसेंटिव जो सब्सिडी
ओके ओके थैंक यू सर
वन मोर क्वेश्चन सर
हेलो
यस हाँ यस सर
हाँ सर वन मोर क्वेश्चन सर कल मैं गया था बाइक खरीदने के लिए शोरूम में और ये सुपर स्प्लेंडर का बाइक जो खरीदने के लिए गया था तो अभी बताया कि न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी आया है कि जो है उसमें कार्बोरेटर नहीं रहेगा कार्बोरेटर को नहीं इन्वॉल्व किया गया है
अच्छा
जो है उसमें डायरेक्ट जो है इंजेक्शन सिस्टम को लगाया गया है मीन्स डायरेक्ट जो है फ्यूल को इंजेक्ट किया जाएगा सिलेंडर में
अच्छा अच्छा
और तो जो है और पहले हम लोग क्या करते थे कि कार्बोरेटर से जो है एयर फ्यूल का मिक्सचर को जो है हम लोग सिलेंडर में प्रोवाइड करते थे लेकिन अभी जो है वो डायरेक्ट जो है हम लोग जो है फ्यूल को जो है सिलेंडर में प्रोवाइड करेंगे तो इससे क्या हमको बेनिफिट मिला ऐसा इस टेक्नोलॉजी को जो है डेवलप किया गया है तो आप बता सकते हैं कि इससे क्या हम लोग को बेनिफिट मिलेगा क्या
बेसिकली सर आई एम फ्रॉम वेरी मच इलेक्ट्रिकल बैकग्राउंड तो थोड़ा सा भी उसका आइडिया मुझे अभी इतना उसका नहीं है बट देयर विल बी अ लिटरेचर आई विल सेंड यू थ्रू दैट ईमेल आईडी आई विल टेक फ्रॉम द विवेक एंड आई कैन सेंड रिलेटेड टू द लिटरेचर टू यू सर
और सर वन मोर क्वेश्चन सर जैसा कि आपने बताया कि इलेक्ट्रिक के बारे में जैसे अभी जो है ये आपका थ्री व्हीलर जो है गाड़ी जो चला है लाइक बैटरी से जो चलता है सेम फंक्शन ये आपने बताया जब ये कार में जो होगा क्या वो अभी बैटरी से जो चलता है जब बैटरी को चार्ज खत्म हो जाता है तो उसको चार्ज करके हम
हाँ वो तो कार में तो दोनों चीजें हैं कि कार में आपका प्योर बैटरी ऑपरेटेड हो सकता है या हाइब्रिड है मतलब ये है लेकिन भाई हाइब्रिड जो है अभी उधर ज्यादा पॉपुलर है हमारा कार लेवल पे जो है ये है क्योंकि वो कार जो भी कार लेवल है उसको हमें रेंज हमें कहीं लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस कवर करना होता है तो लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस कवर करना वो अभी हमारे लिए क्या है कि प्योर इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल से चैलेंज ही है तो इसलिए अभी हाइब्रिड इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल प्रीफर करते हैं कार के बदले
और सर ये क्या स्पीड जो है जो भी स्पीड है जो भी आपका ब्रेक हॉर्स पावर है जो भी सीसी है ये जो है इन कंपैरिजन जो है आईसी इंजन के इक्विवेलेंट है कि उससे लेस है कि उससे ज्यादा है
सच सीसी तो यहाँ ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता है जहां तक मुझे पता है, क्योंकि यहाँ तो हमारा मोटर है और बैटरी में कितनी एनर्जी स्टोर्ड है उसके अकॉर्डिंग जो है हम ऑपरेट करते हैं, ये है। और उस स्पीड कितनी हम मोटर को कैसे पावर दे रहे हैं, कितना पावर दे रहे हैं टू इंक्रीज द स्पीड, उसके अकॉर्डिंग हमारी बैटरी से एनर्जी जो है वो खत्म होती रहती है। तो बैटरी को ज्यादा एनर्जी को स्टोर करने के लिए हमें ज्यादा बैटरी
उसकी साइज इंक्रीज। मेरा बताना था कि क्या जो है स्पीड वगैरह जो हम लोग को जो है आईसी इंजन से मिलता है उतना ही जो है स्पीड इससे भी मिल पाएगा कि उससे कम भी मिल पाएगा जो है
स्पीड? सर स्पीड तो कंपेरेबल है, मतलब स्पीड तो आप कर लेंगे, ये है स्पीड में कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं आएगी, लेकिन प्रॉब्लम जो है उसकी कैपेसिटी, जैसे लोड कैपेसिटी में है आपका करना बैटरी की, बैटरी ऑपरेटेड इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल के साथ वो एक चैलेंज है, और रेंज का चैलेंज है, स्पीड ऐसा प्रॉब्लम नहीं है सर।
और सर जैसे आपने बताया कि जो है हमारा बैटरी जो है खत्म हो जाएगा, तो ऐसा ऐसा स्टेशन जो है बनाया जा रहा है कि जो है तुरंत एक्सचेंज लोग जो है तुरंत एक्सचेंज बैटरी करके हमको नया जो है चार्ज जो है बैटरी उसको हम लोग प्रोवाइड कर दिया जाएगा।
ये तो है,
ऐसा 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 जो है सिस्टम इसमें जनरेट नहीं किया जाता है कि वो ऑटो जो है बैटरी भी चार्ज होता रहे, जो है हमारा जो इंजन स्टार्ट है लाइक डायनमो जो है उस टाइप से इसमें सिस्टम नहीं डेवलप किया जा सकता है कि ऑटो हमारा बैटरी भी चार्ज होता रहे, जो हमारा इंजन जब चालू हो, हम जब गाड़ी में हम मूव करते रहते हैं, सफर करते रहते हैं, तो ऑटोमेटिकली हमारा जो है बैटरी भी चार्ज होता रहे।
हाँ हाँ सर, ऐसा सिस्टम जैसा आप बोल रहे हैं, दिस इज वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन हियर, और यहाँ पे जो है उसको हम कर सकते हैं कि सब फ्यूचर जो हमारे रिसर्च है ये इन्हीं सब पे ही बेस्ड होंगे। तो ऐसी ऐसी चीजों की पॉसिबिलिटी है, तो वो हमारा एज लॉन्ग एज जैसे जैसे इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स में रिसर्च ग्रो करेगा, तो इस तरीके की टेक्नोलॉजी को जो है इनकॉर्पोरेट किया जाएगा, मतलब किया है या इसकी पॉसिबिलिटी रहेगी फ्यूचर
में। मेन जो है डिबेट है कि जैसे हम लोग जो है बहुत दूर तक जर्नी कर रहे हैं, तो उसमें हो सकता है कि इसमें जो है डिफिनेट आदमी जो है सियर होकर नहीं चलेगा कि भाई हमारा कब जो है बैटरी खत्म हो जाएगा, क्या डिफिनेट होकर आदमी जो है
देखिए सर। हाँ, इसमें एक चीज और है कि जब बैटरी को एक टाइम पे तो एक ही काम कराएंगे, फिर इस मीन से सम अलग से, जैसे डायनेमो का जो कंसेप्ट आप बता रहे हैं सर, वो उसमें क्या है कि बैटरी तो पावर दे रहा है, वो तो पावर फ्लो इन एट वन टाइम वन डायरेक्शन, तो वो क्या है कि फिर वो कोई दूसरी बैटरी चार्ज करनी पड़ेगी, फिर उसको लेटर ऑन वी विल यूज दैट बैटरी टू प्रोपेल द आवर ड्राइव सिस्टम।
ओके, और सर ये जो है ये आपका एसी भी जो है इसमें प्रोवाइड होगा इस टाइप का इंजन में जो भी है?
हाँ, एसी देखिए सर, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन वो पावर कैसना, लो पावर में जो है हम लोग डीसी सप्लाई यूज करते हैं और डीसी मोटर यूज कर लेते हैं, जैसे ब्रशलेस डीसी मोटर है। हाई पावर में जो है वो हम इंडक्शन या
जो भी आईसी इंजन है जनरली उसमें जो है एसी का जो है रहता है सिस्टम की, एसी चालू कर सकते हैं हम लोग जो है लगा सकते हैं, तो ये जो इलेक्ट्रिक सप्लाई जो है।
अरे वो तो सर है, अभी वो जस्ट हमने खुद एसी, ये सारी चीजें हमने खुद यहाँ पे हमारे है एक हाइब्रिड व्हीकल है हमारे कैंपस में, तो वो करीब उसमें सब सारे प्रोसेस हैं। एसी को हम लोग जो है उस इनिशियली उसमें दो मोड होते हैं कि पहले हम एसी को और ऑक्सिलरी पावर सोर्सेज और भी जो जरूरत है हम बैटरी से देते हैं। अगर हमको बहुत जब हाई स्पीड पे जा रहे हैं फिर दोनों सिस्टम को ऑन करते हैं, दोनों मतलब कि फ्यूल सेल को भी, सॉरी आईसी इंजन को भी, और बैटरी तो चल ही रहा है। तो ये प्रोविजन तो है, मतलब ये तो है ही, लेकिन दैट कार इज वेरी कॉस्टली, अराउंड आई हैव सीन अराउंड इट्स कॉस्ट इज 42 लाख, तो उसमें तो ये सारे प्रोविजन मैंने खुद ही इन्वेस्टिगेट किए हैं यहाँ पे।
नहीं, जैसे बैटरी से जो है हम लोग जो है चलाते हैं गाड़ी को मूव कर रहे हैं, हम बैटरी से एसी को मूव करना चाहेंगे तो बैटरी का कंजम्पशन बहुत ज्यादा होगा, मेरा जल्दी बैटरी खत्म हो जाएगा।
बट सर बैटरी का कंजम्पशन होगा नो डाउट, बट अगर आईसी इंजन चलाएंगे तो आईसी इंजन से देंगे तो वो फ्यूल का जो इफिशियंसी होती है वो और भी पुअर होगी देन बैटरी से अगर हम पावर दे रहे हैं तो बैटरी। तो ये इसीलिए तो व्हीकल्स में जितने भी ऑक्सिलरी पावर सोर्सेज की जहां जरूरत होती है वी प्रिफर द बैटरी सिस्टम, बैटरी से एनर्जी देना खत्म तो होगा लेकिन कंपेयर करना पड़ेगा उससे आईसी इंजन से अगर पावर दे रहे हैं कि हम बैटरी से दे रहे हैं जी है
okay, तो उस केस में जो वो जो है तो फिर तो पोल्यूशन तो होगा ही सर, जो आईसी इंजन हम लोग यूज करेंगे तो।
हाँ वो दोनों चीजें है ना, फ्यूल कंजम्पशन और पॉल्यूशन दोनों को प्रिवेंट करने के लिए हम लोग ऐसे करते हैं कि ज्यादा से ज्यादातर टाइम जो है बैटरी को यूज करें जी।
ओके सर थैंक यू सर,
थैंक यू सर,
धन्यवाद सर आपको,
थैंक यू अनिल सर फॉर द वेरी नाइस इंटरेक्शन। So I think sir we should end the session and now no more questions are from student side, faculty side. So on the behalf of Government Engineering College Vaishali, Prince respected principal sir, Government Engineering College Vaishali, I would like to thank you respected Ankit sir for giving his precious time for our students. The session was very nice, he really enjoyed the session and lot of confusions are there in the mind of ours and students regarding electrical vehicle and their future aspect as far as India is concerned and as well as far as world is concerned. Thank you Ankit sir for enlightening us, the session was very nice, and thank you all the faculty member and student for patiently listening the session, and for this behalf on the permission of Ankit sir we would like to wind up the session.
Thank you all the members of the GEC and assistant professor Vivek for giving such a nice opportunity to discuss the content of the electric vehicle.
Thank you sir, thank you all.